I mean, I've played everything, and I play, you know, sometimes the small jazz club or the coffee house, and sometimes the big shed for thousands of people. It changes all the time for different reasons. And I think it's important to keep that elasticity in your career. Sometimes it's harder to play for a small group of people because they're right there in your lap and you can see their expressions. Sometimes it's easier to be distant from the audience. You feel more private and you can kind of get lost in your own little world and the spotlight is shining in your eyes. So it's important to keep the diversity.
We played up at the Elbow Room in New York last night, and we've been playing in all kind of different venues. We've been doing a lot of festivals.
We've done every possible venue setting you can imagine in the last few years. We've played, this is probably the biggest festival we played, although, you know, we've played like Midtown Music Festival, Atlanta's huge, Sunfest down in Florida, huge. We really enjoy the festivals because you get to play with so many other bands.
Since I've been recording, I haven't been playing out a lot, but I played, like in New York, I played in a, where did I play? I played in a great club in New York called the Fez. It's kind of like a cabaret type situation where there's a stage and a lot of tables and chairs. And then the festivals, and right now I'm about to go to Europe to play with the Counting Crows. That'll mainly be theaters, you know, 2,000 people. That'll be cool.
Clubs. We've been doing a lot of club dates, but mostly on this promotion, and we do a lot of like these multi-artist venues that radio stations provide. But we actually like smaller clubs because it's intimate and you can touch people.
Oh, let's see. I've performed at the Astoria in New York. No, the Astoria is in London, excuse me. The Palladium I performed at, which was like both of those clubs are really huge. So those kind of venues I like to play the most.
Oh, you know, over the years we've done it all. We've done everything from, you know, I started out in clubs and then I did opening slots for people in anything from these kind of sheds to stadiums with Tina Turner in Europe. And it doesn't really matter to me. I mean, I've had just as much fun in Nashville in front of 150,000 people, you know, on the river, as I have in front of 200 people in a small club. You know, I mean, it's not about the size or the sound of the venue. It's about the attitude of the people that have paid to see you. And, you know, believe me, I've performed in front of 15,000 sleepy people, and I've also performed in front of 100 people that sounded like 20,000. So, you know, it's kind of a hit and miss kind of thing.
We've been running the full gamut. We've always been that way. We played in the early days a lot of clubs and stuff like that, but we play the big halls and the outdoor festivals and the little clubs. We've done it that way all our career, so why stop now?
Well, we've done the last tour that we did, we did small venues, like 3,000 to 5,000 seaters, and theaters, stuff like that. And but I've done a lot of festivals too. I guess kind of go back and forth, but nothing more than 5,000 people.
Well, mainly, you know, on my kind of headlining tour, it's like large clubs and small theaters, anywhere from 500 to 1500 seat venues. And I quite like that. I mean, I like playing in theaters because I'm doing pretty mellow music in general, and so people are sitting down, they can be attentive, they listen and they watch, and I appreciate that very much. In clubs sometimes there's a little bit more of a party atmosphere, and then you have to contend with that reality, and that's more difficult for me. But yeah, it's like anything else. You have good nights and bad nights, and you try and adapt a little bit to the situation, you know.
Hold on to that guitar. The Music Mill Source will be right back.
thousand eyes are on me.
Yeah. Do it, Casey, do it.
Shouting, Casey, go all the way.
Casey, do it.
Score.
Come on, Casey.
First base, second base, third base. Make your move today. Do it, Casey, do it.
Do it.
Score mighty, Casey, score.
Score, score.
I just don't get it. Is that what girls are for? If you don't talk with your kids about sex, who will? A free booklet can help.
Hello, I am the Queen of England, and you're listening to the Music Mill. Actually, I really wish I was Bob Guccione Jr., editor of Spin. That would be much cooler than being the Queen of England. But anyway, hello, all my friends at the Music Mill.
And what determines what type of venue you're going to be performing at?
If it's acoustic show, I try to play someplace where I can feel intimate with the audience and, you know, usually a place with table and chairs. If it's a band, if we're playing very rock music, I try to have a place where people can stand. I try to play clubs where it can be all ages. That's mainly.
It's the record company, because they know best. For example, the record company in the States, they're going to know best where our song is, whatever, in the top 10, that people request the song in that radio station, and that's what we'll perform. So,
actually, no, I don't really have any control of it. It's like, my agent, he like picks out, you know, which ones are the best ones to go to, which ones will reach the most people, and also the money is definitely involved, so can't lie about that.
Well, you know, my touring, whereas I used to be a touring machine the first couple of albums, I didn't have kids then, so my touring is very limited now, and I don't really care, I don't make those decisions in answer to your question, but the only decision I have made that certainly troubles the record company and the management company and the agency is that I won't be away from my kids for very long. So my ability to tour is very limited, because I'm just not willing to get on a plane or a bus and come back in 6 or 8 or 10 months. Those days for me are over. My priorities are being there for my kids. You know, I'm not going to pass up watching my kids first anything for doing a gig. I've done enough gigs. I've done, 1,200 gigs already in my life. I love it. I love the 2 hours on stage, but it's not worth the 2 hours I miss from being with my kids. My number one job is to be a dad.
It's mostly set up by our agency, ICM, but our management and the band have a hand in saying what venues we're going to play and what venues are not. But mostly it's ICM that books the band, so.
To some degree, I have an agent, of course, CAA, Creative Arts Agency in Los Angeles, and my agent and my manager, David Lionheart, they communicate a lot, and then David will run things by me. If we have an option to play in two different places in a given city, he'll say, well, this is the one place, the guarantee is this much, and this is the situation, and here's the other place, the guarantee is this much, and this situation. Sometimes, in Chicago, I chose to play a place with a lesser guarantee because it was a cooler club, and it's a better vibe for what I was doing. So, you have to make some decisions based on what's good for your art,
And what goes into choosing what type of place you're going to play? Is that something you have control over, or is that more of a management record label type of deal?
Well, it's more like a promoter, agent type of thing. But for me, the norm is to try to keep things as intimate as possible, because I think it's really bad when, at least from my point, the kind of music that I do, not to be in touch with the people and to be as personal as possible.
Well, it depends where you are. I think certainly, somebody like John Mellencamp is in the position to kind of have his pick, and it's a nice opportunity for him to do a tour like this where the settings are a lot more intimate. Gives his audience a chance to not be in a shed setting, where you're one out of 25,000 people. We've had the opportunity over the last year to play a variety of different venues. We've done, 300-seat clubs. We've done 2,000-seat theaters. We've done amphitheaters, it depends really what you're doing. If you're in an opening position, certainly you don't have a choice. You're subject to whatever the headliner's doing. But as a headlining act, we've had the opportunity to do a lot of different stuff.
Yeah. 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 Uncle Don to your hat.
Your hat.
The Music Mill Souls.
We becoming
right.
We
becoming
right.
Must I, Amanda, take this guy to heaven to hold, to go out with and make out with, to be together and sleep together, to go all the way, because they say he'll walk away, unless I do.
If you don't talk with your kids about sex, who will? Our free booklet can help.
Hi, it's Bert Holman from the Allman Brothers Band, the manager, and I want to say hi to all my friends out on the Music Mill.
Hush, little baby, why do you cry? Will all our friends catch AIDS and die? Is there AIDS on the windowsill? Will it kill Humpty and Jack and Jill? What if Mother Goose goes to... Or even worse, she gives it to you.
If you don't talk with your kids about AIDS, who knows what they'll imagine? Our free booklet can help.
If you had to choose your most favorite music venue to date, which one would that be and why?
Wow, there's a really nice theater in Chicago. I don't remember what it's called. But it was one of those huge places with tables and chairs, and it was intimate, and people could listen to what you were doing, and it was still a... Sometimes when you play places like that, it's almost like a library. It's so quiet. But this place was, they were focused, but it was a very music kind of place. I don't know how to describe it. Yeah.
And you just answered my second question, which was if you had to choose your most favorite venue, which one would that be and why? Is it the same for all of you?
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Club is the best. You're really close to the fans. You have really like, the whole vibe is very, you know, energetic. The big venues, they're cool, it's good for the image and all that stuff, but, you know, it's still very far away from the audience. Mm-hmm. Very big stage, you have to run a lot. So
we play club music, so it's kind of like at home there, you know.
I'd have to say the Palladium, because they gave me so much love there. And, you know, as an artist, when you're performing, when people give you appreciation for what you do, you, like, really get off. It's like being on a natural high. And so they really gave it to me, so that had to be my favorite place.
Royal Albert Hall in London, because I just had an amazing experience there, and it's I think part of it was that I was warned that venue would... Because I'd seen Clapton there, and everybody just sat on their hands the whole night. It was a beautiful, beautiful place and a great sounding venue. But London can be kind of a stiff place to see concerts for audiences, number one. And number two, that room is very cold and very stiff audiences. But I still wanted to play it just to play it. And we did it, and it was like it was my living room. I mean, people were dancing and jumping up and down, much to my surprise. So that was one of those magical nights for me at Royal Albert Hall.
I would say the Music Mill is probably my favorite place to play. You know, that's...
Funny thing, that's mine too.
It's got to be the highlight of anybody's career, you know, wouldn't you guess? We play every size place. Sometimes we've played for as little as no people. And if we feel good about it, you know, that's all that matters. We've played some big places and that's been awful, but we've played big places have been great. So I think just the fact that we get to play we're very lucky.
Personal best?
I think my favorite place to play is probably the Royal Albert Hall in London.
I've had some really good shows like at the Metro in Chicago. I've had really good shows at Mercury Lounge in New York City. I've had really good shows at the Troubadour in Los Angeles. Trying to think, I played in a great place in Seattle called the King Cat Theater. You know, there's just, it's not so much dependent on the venue, although that can help, but it's just many factors that combine to make it a good night.
Oh my God, it's hard to say. I really don't have one. I mean, there's so many great places around the country that around the world that have been great for me.
And your personal preference?
I don't have one. I honestly, it makes absolutely no difference to me whatsoever. It really depends on the show. You know, a great outdoor show can be in front of 25,000 people can be just as intimate and exciting and great as a show in front of 300 people in a club. It makes absolutely no difference.
Somebody. Many of the theme songs for this television program were written and produced by Peter Keyes Berwin, who writes songs before they become hits for the commercial music industry. Now with over 400 songs in catalog unpublished and available, stream Peter Keyes Berwin music at any of the websites shown on the screen.
This program was partially produced in cooperation with the New England Music Mill Rehearsal Complex, the home of many of New England's premier bands and musicians. For band and musician rehearsal space, contact the phone number or website shown on the screen.